So this next section has two useful theorems that we will see come up in a variety of applications as we prove other theorems, as we work through future sections, well beyond even this course. These, especially the mean value theorem, will be utilized. So let's spend a little bit of time exploring them and talking about them and doing some examples. So this first one is called Rolle's theorem. And Rolle's theorem says this. It says that if we have a function that satisfies the following three conditions, that it is continuous on a closed interval from A to B, it is differentiable on an open interval, A, B, and f of A equals f of B. Okay? So if you wanted to right now, just on your paper, just draw, and I have some examples down below, but on your paper, draw any function that satisfies that. So take a function from A to B and draw a function so that f of A equals f of B and it is continuous and differentiable. So don't lift up your pencil as you draw from A to B. Start at wherever you start at A, make sure you end at B. F of A is equal to f of B. Don't lift up your pencil. Make sure you have a continuous function from A to B, the closed interval from A to B. And don't draw any sharp corners or cusps because it's also differentiable. So remember, you want a continuous function, a differentiable function, and you want f of A to equal f of B. So give that a try and, you know, draw whatever function you want. You can draw your favorite function. I'm going to draw a little squiggly throughout here. Draw whatever function you want as long as you start and end f of A equals f of B. And you have a continuous and differentiable function. So no corners or cusps on that differentiability and continuous, make sure they don't lift up your pencil. So those are the three conditions of Rolle's theorem. And I've scooched off of the actual statement of Rolle's theorem, but what Rolle's theorem says is if these three conditions are met, and it's, you know, intuitively and graphically, I hope this makes sense to you. If these three conditions are met, then there has to be at least one place where we have a horizontal tangent line. So if where you start is the same location that you end at, right? If f of A equals f of B, and to get from one point to the next, you have a continuous function, so you don't jump or have gaps or holes, continuous function, and you're differentiable, so you also don't have any places where the derivative doesn't exist, like a corner or a cusp, then there has to be at least, now on the one I just drew, there's actually one, two, three, four, five, six. I made six places. So I've got C1, C2. So see if you can identify them on your graph. See if you can find those places on your graph where you have a horizontal tangent. So Rolle's theorem says that there has to be at least one. I have one that actually has six. So it turns out that C sub i are such that are all points in the open interval from A to B where f prime of c sub I equals zero. That's my particular example. And I use c sub I just because I had six of them, right? So I is equal to the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 for me, because I actually had six places. It could be that you only have one, but you will have at least one. So you're going to have at least one as long as you meet these conditions. And you may have more than one. You might have actually an infinite number of them. And how would we have an infinite number? Well, I'll show you that in just a second. So that's the criteria. So you've got your three conditions, continuous, differentiable, and the two endpoints are equal, f of A equals f of B. Then there has to be at least one. Okay, so I wrote x equals c here. There is a number. Could be that there's more than one. So there's at least, that is implied in this statement, at least one point C in the interval from A to B, such that f prime of C equals zero horizontal tangent. So that's what Rolle's theorem says. And here are three examples in my fourth example, the fourth one I drew just a second ago. And what you can see is on all of these, so on the second, the ones that have some curvature to them, you can see those horizontal tangents. I drew them in. But even a horizontal line meets these conditions because it is a continuous and differentiable function, okay, from A to B. And it turns out that every single point, there are actually an infinite number, all the points, all value. So this is the one that would have an infinite number of value. All values C in the interval, open interval from A to B, have a derivative that is equal to zero. There's actually an infinite number of them, right? There's an infinite number of points in between A and B, and all of them have a derivative. All of them have a horizontal tangent line. All of them have a derivative equal to zero. So that's what Rolle's theorem says. And we are going to use it to do a couple quick examples here just to see it in practice. But intuitively, that's what it says. I am not going to go through the formal proof here, but the formal proof is laid out nicely by cases within the textbook. So check that out if you want to see the formal proof here. We went through sort of just an intuitive sense of it, but the formal proof is included in the book. So let's go ahead and get to a couple examples. All right, so let's take some problems. And again, you know, a theorem works only if you meet the criteria of the hypothesis, right? Like you can only apply a theorem if you meet the conditions of the theorem. And so the first thing when we're applying these two theorems, Rolle's theorem, and then in a minute, later on in this section, mean value theorem, we first have to verify that we satisfy the conditions, right? That we actually satisfy Rolle's theorem. So remember, Rolle's theorem has those three conditions. We have to be continuous, differentiable, and f of a has to equal f of b. So we have to be continuous actually on the closed interval, differentiable on the open interval, and f of a equals f of b. In this particular case, we need to show that f of 0 equals f of 2. So plugging in the actual numbers from this particular example. Okay, we've got a polynomial. Polynomials are continuous everywhere. Therefore, you know, we could make a quick statement here that we are continuous since f of x is a polynomial. Polynomials are continuous on their domains, so they're continuous from negative infinity to infinity, which obviously covers 0 to 2. Okay. Similarly, polynomials are differentiable in their domains as well. So we could say since f of x is a polynomial. But we do need to pause for a second and we need to think about those two things since it's continuous from negative infinity to infinity and differentiable from negative infinity to infinity, it will definitely be on the interval from 0 to 2. Okay, so then the third condition, we do have to look at what is f of 0, and f of 0 is 7. And then we need to look at f of 2, because to meet the third, to even apply Rolle's theorem, we got to meet all these three conditions. So what is f of 2? Let's see, 8 minus 4 minus 4 plus 7. That is as well 7. So f of 0 does equal f of 2. They're both equal to 7. So we could put a little check mark. Okay, so check, check, check. We met all three conditions. And so if we meet all three conditions, what Rolle's theorem says is that there has to be a point where the derivative equals 0 that is within 0 to 2. You know, it could be that it's outside of it, but since it met these three conditions, there will have to be at least one of those values within the interval from 0 to 2. So now let's actually find, running into my second example, but I think we can fit it. So now let's find the C values in the interval from 0 to 2 where f prime of C equals 0. Okay, so that is now the goal. Well, to do that, we're going to have to, let's go ahead and come over here, we're going to have to take the derivative. So we'll take the derivative. So what is f prime of x? I lost my f of x there for a second. It's 3x squared minus 2x minus 2 plus 0. So we want to know, when does this equal 0? And so look at that. Let's see. I'm not going to factor. Did a little quick check in my head if it was going to factor, but it is not. So then we'll go to the quadratic formula. Remember, right, we always have other techniques for solving: rational roots theorem, quadratic formula if it's a quadratic. So whatever we've got to do, we've got ways to do it. And so we'll head into the quadratic formula here. So x is going to be 2 plus or minus the square root of 4 minus 4 times 3 times negative 2 all over 6. Let's see here. 4 plus 24 will be 28 over 6. And I do want to come up with the exact values here. So we'll approximate as well, but let's go ahead and simplify this a little bit further. This is 4 times 7. So just simplifying that, I get 2 root 7 over 6. And so my possibilities here, that also reduces all of those reduced by 2. So 1 plus or minus root 7 over 3. All right. So these end up giving me two values. 1 plus root 7 over 3, which is approximately, and I pop that into the calculator, 1.215. And 1 minus root 7 over 3, which is not actually going to be in my interval because it comes out as negative 0.549. So that is a place where the derivative, notice both of these are places where we have horizontal tangents. Again, nothing new on that. We've done that before. But we want the one, these are both places where we have horizontal tangents. We want the one that is in the interval by Rolle's theorem. And so the interval that we were looking at was from 0 to 2. And so we want to pull the one of these that is in, or we want to show that one of these, that there was at least one, and there is one from 0 to 2, and it is right here. It is this one. Let's circle the whole thing, actually, not just the approximation. So we know that there is at least one value. And what we can say is that it's at x equals 1 plus root 7 over 3, which is approximately 1.215. We could say C, actually. Well, let's write it this way, which is in the interval from 0 to 2. That's how I'm going to write it. And it satisfies Rolle's condition. So there was one, at least one, and we found it. This satisfies Rolle's theorem. There's that one point that satisfies Rolle's theorem. Okay, let's look at another one. So let's take a look at this guy. So what if we had 9 minus x to the 2/3 on the interval from negative 27 to positive 27. So again, the three conditions that we have to satisfy, we have to be continuous on negative 27 to 27. And so over here, let's check that. So turns out that this function is continuous on its domain. We have no division by 0. It is a cube root. So cube roots give us the ability to take both positive and negative values. So the domain here is all reals, or negative infinity to infinity. So we're definitely continuous from negative 27 to 27. Then we need to consider, where is it differentiable? So the other, the second condition of Rolle's theorem is it differentiable from negative 27 to 27? Non-inclusive of the endpoints. So is it differentiable? Well, I'm going to put a question mark. Differentiable. We don't quite know yet until we take the derivative and consider. So it's not like a polynomial. I mean, maybe this is one that you've thought about, but it's not like a polynomial that we've worked with a lot. This is one that we might want to think about for a second here. And so if I take the derivative, 9, of course, becomes 0, I get negative 2/3 x to the minus 1/3, which becomes a negative 2 over 3x to the 1/3, or negative 2 over 3 times the cube root of x. Now remember, the domain is from negative infinity to infinity, so we can plug any number into the function, but notice here that the denominator, we now have a denominator where we did not have a denominator in the function. We now have a denominator. So when we're thinking about what the domain of this function is, or when this function is differentiable, notice I didn't put the prime there. I need to put the prime there. This is g prime of x. That the denominator cannot be 0, right? We can't have, the denominator can't be 0 because that would create division by 0. So the function, the derivative, is not defined when the denominator of the derivative is 0. So when would the denominator be 0? Well, when x is 0. So notice that g prime of x is undefined at x equals 0. And that bumps us out of being able to use Rolle's theorem, because notice now, notice that x equals 0 is in the interval from negative 27 to 27. It's right smack in the middle of it. And we just showed that the derivative is undefined at 0. So we cannot apply Rolle's theorem. We don't meet the conditions. We can't apply Rolle's theorem. Okay. Rolle's theorem is basically invalid, I guess, here. It's just not applicable. Maybe not invalid is not the right way to say it. It's just not applicable. We can't apply Rolle's theorem here because we have a point where the derivative is undefined. And in order to use Rolle's theorem, the derivative has to be defined on the open interval that we're looking at. Now, that said, you might have even gotten to part three. I didn't even write part three here, but you might have gotten to part three where f of a equals f of b. And I won't go through that computation, but it turns out that that condition is met. So it turns out this condition's met, this condition's met. It's this one that is not. But, you know, it's not worth going any further because we know that it's not differentiable. So if it's not differentiable, basically what that means is that there could be a point. It could have that turnaround point, you know, to get back to f of a and f of b being equal. It could have a turnaround point on the graph that's a corner or a cusp rather than the horizontal asymptote that we would be looking for. So I want to just show you that on the graph. We can't apply Rolle's theorem here. It's just not valid. It's not saying that Rolle's theorem, you know, it's just not valid. It's not applicable. So we can't use it. And I do want to show you that, what I talked about, the corner or the cusp, because that's actually exactly what's happening. So let's take this last example on this video and let's just end over in Desmos. I'm going to pause it. We'll pop to Desmos and take a look at that graph. And so here we have the graph. Here's that function we were looking at, 9 minus x to the 2/3. And I'll go ahead and just hide that so we can zoom in on the graph. And what you can see, so we were looking at it from negative 27 to positive 27 here. I didn't restrict the domain, but you can see exactly what's happening, right? Like this would be a place where Rolle's theorem is not, it's not that Rolle's theorem is faulty, it simply just doesn't apply because there is definitely a point here where we have that turnaround, but it's happening at a cusp where the derivative doesn't exist. And so I wanted to show this example because this is why you have to check those conditions, because we can't apply a theorem unless we meet the conditions. And here is a perfect example of if we had just kind of gone through the process and said, oh yeah, the f of a equals f of b, there's got to be a point where the derivative equals 0, we would have had a faulty answer. All right. So that is Rolle's theorem, and we'll come back on our second video with mean value theorem.